स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट कम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ अ एल्गोरिथम. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस सम मोर एग्जांपल्स. फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इज एन एल्गोरिथम इज गिवन इन विच फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज इनिशियलाइजेशन स्टेटमेंट. सो इट्स टाइम कम्प्लेक्सिटी इज बी ओ वन बिकॉज इट विल टेक कॉन्स्टेंट अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम. सेकेंड, वी हैव अ फॉर लूप विच विल रन फॉर एम टाइम्स एंड इन दिस फॉर लूप we have a statement which is taking constant amount of time. So time complexity of this for loop is big of m. Similarly, time complexity of this for loop is big of n. Now these loops are sequential loops, so we can add their time complexity. Hence time complexity of this complete algorithm is big of 1 plus big of m plus big of n. So it will be equal to big of m plus n. Hence, this is the answer. Next, in this example, we have two loops which are nested loops. In previous example, loops were sequential loops. So now we will multiply their time complexity. Now, time complexity of first loop is big of m because it will run for m times. Similarly, time complexity of second loop is big of n. So time complexity of the algorithm is big of m into n. Next, in this for loop, we have I is equal to 1 to n, and every time we are multiplying I by 2. So we can say that total number of iterations will be for I equal to 1, 2, 4, 8, so on up to 2 raised to power k, because every time we are multiplying I by 2, so last term will also be a multiple of 2. We have assumed that 2 raised to power k is equal to n. Now this loop will break when 2 raised to power k will be greater than n. Taking log both sides, we will get log of 2 raised to power k greater than log of n, which will be equal to k greater than log n base 2. So there will be log n base 2 iterations because we have assumed that there are k iterations in this loop. Hence time complexity of this algorithm is big of log n base 2. Now if instead of this statement we have statement I is equal to I into 3, then again this loop will run for I is equal to 1, 3, 9 and 3 raised to power k. Then answer would have been log n base 3. Next, here we have a outer for loop which is run for n times, so total number of iteration is n, hence its complexity is big of n. Next, again we have a loop which is nested loop and its iteration will be n by 2 because we are incrementing j every time by 2, so its complexity will be big of n by 2. Total complexity of algorithm is equal to big of n into big of n by 2, which will be equal to big of n square because we have ignored the coefficient of the leading term. Next example, here we have outer loop which will run for n times, so its complexity is big of n. Second loop which is running from 1 to n and every time we are multiplying j by 2. So it is similar to example 3, and in that example we calculated the complexity which is equal to log n base 2. Third, that is k loop which is running from 1 to n, so its complexity is big of n. So these loops are nested loops. Time complexity of the algorithm is big of n into big of log n base 2 into big of n. So this is equal to big of n square log n base 2. Next example. In this example, we have a outer loop which is running from I is equal to n to 1, and we have a inner loop which is depending on the value of I. So how we will solve this? Suppose I is n, then j loop will run from 1 to n. So total n iterations will be there. Next, I will be n by 2. J loop will run from j is equal to 1 to n by 2. So total n by 2 iterations will be there. Similarly, last value of I will be 1, J loop will run for one time and total one iterations will be there. Now, complexity of this algorithm will depend on total number of iterations of these two loops. So, total number of iterations of these loops will be equal to addition of all these terms. So, that is n plus n by 2 plus n by 4 plus up to 1. Taking n as common, we will get 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by n. Let us assume that 2 raised to power k is equal to n. So we can say this is equal to n into 1 by 2 raised to power 0 plus 1 by 2 raised to power 1 plus 1 by 2 raised to power 2 and plus 1 by 2 raised to power k. Now this is a GP and sum of n terms of GP is equal to a into 1 minus r raised to power n by 1 minus r, where r is less than 1. Here our r is 1 by 2. So this will be equal to n into a. A is 1 into 1 minus r, that is 1 by 2 raised to power n. Here n is number of term, which is k plus 1 in our case, divide by 1 minus 1 by 2. So this will be equal to 2n into 1 minus 1 by 2 raised to power k plus 1, which is equal to 2n into 1 minus 1 by 2 raised to power k into 2. Putting 2 raised to power k is equal to n, we will get 2n into 1 minus 1 by 2n. Solving this, we will get 2n minus 1. Now, complexity of this algorithm is big of n, because the leading term is 2n and we have ignored the coefficient. Last example is, again, we have three loops and first loop is running from I is equal to 1 to n. Second loop is depending upon value of I. So we will solve. If I is 1, then j will run for 1 time and k will run for 100 times, because k loop is running 1 to 100 for every iteration of j. Similarly, if I is 2, then j loop will run for 1 and 2, k loop will run for 200 times. Why? First 100 for j is equal to 1, second 100 for j is equal to 2. So we can say total number of iterations will be 2 into 100. Similarly, if I is n, j loop will run from 1 to n, and total number of iterations for k loop will be n into 100. Now, complexity of this algorithm is dependent upon total number of iterations of these three loops. Total number of iterations of these three loops is equal to addition of all these iterations. So we can say that this is equal to 100 plus 2 into 100 plus 3 into 100 up to so on plus n into 100. Taking 100 as common, here we will get 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to plus n. This is equal to summation n. So we can say this is 100 into summation n. Formula for summation n is n into n plus 1 by 2. So this is equal to 50n plus 50n square. Leading term is n square, and ignoring its coefficient, we will get complexity of this algorithm is big of n square. So this is our final answer. So hope these examples are clear to you and you will be able to solve other examples. In the next lecture, we will discuss about recursive functions. Thank you.